the sun'll come out tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow there'll be sun. Just thinking about tomorrow clears away the cobwebs and the sorrow till there's none. When I'm stuck with a day that's gray and lonely, I just stick out my chin and grin and say, oh, the sun'll come out.
Welcome to another dramatic reading by me, AnzaN84. Today we are finally going to get to the end of the Misery Sensei Near Zero Double Blitzkrieg debacle, which by this point is a single Blitzkrieg. Even for Near Zero, well, the rest of its title still works. Anyway, we're down to our last terrorist group, the Neo-Nazis. So, without further ado, on with the reading. Gentry, Mera, and Mamoru were both pacing the floor. Greeting was the highest part in any battle. One did not know until the troops came back as to who survived and who was injured or dead. They could just look out the window. It got to be okay, Mamoru finally said. Suddenly there was a blinding flash of light. Sagi, Daria, Ami, Jane, Trent, Jesse, Mac, and Jody had finished with their teleportation. Mamoru couldn't hold back his feelings. Yusako, you're back! Mamoru said as he ran to her and kissed her. I was worried, then took a look at Daria. Daria, what's with the bikini? Oh, God. Long story, Mamoru, Daria said. Mamoru noticed about Ami was with them. Ami, you're alive! What happened? Daria just said, it's a long story, Ami said. Daria turned back to her and said, guys, I want you to meet my friends. Who's she talking to? She began with Jane and went from left to right. This is Jane Lane, that's her brother Trent. The guy next to him is Jesse Moreno. The black guy is Michael Jordan. Michael Jordan's in this. Come on, slam, and welcome to the jam. Mackenzie, we just call him Mac. And the black woman with women. There's multiple women. With him is Joey Landon. Everyone is again Terry Murakagi of the Japan Self Air Defense. Air Self-Defense Force, along with Chiba Mamoru, aka his slash marks are unnecessary. Tuxedo Mask. Tuxedo Mask extended his hand to him and said, welcome to Japan. I wish it was under better circumstances. Hey man, it was one strange trip, Trent replied. How are things here? Sailor Moon asked. Not good, Tuxedo Mask said. Because Brett's have been bombed to rubble. You now, Yoriko and Neo Zero are heading for the Imperial Palace. We've got to stop her. Ryu, Governor Guy, and the Solar Warrior return. You better turn on the TV and tune into NHK, Ryu said. The Emperor is giving a speech. TV was turned on. There on NHK was the entire Imperial family. Emperor Akihito, Empress Michiko, Crown Prince Naohito and his wife, Crown Princess Masako. And all the other immediate members were the Prime Minister and members of the Cabinet. Background was Imperial Standard, which had the Imperial Mon or Crest of a yellow 16-petaled chrysanthemum on a red field along the Prime Minister's flag with five white chrysanthemums in a pentagon arrangement on the yellow field and a Vermilion National flag with a red disc on a white filed. The Emperor stood up. Citizens of Japan, the hasty Emperor began. We stand at a perilous crossroads in our nation's long history. Your forces here in this nation who are trying to destroy over half a century of peaceful democratic progress. None of the controls would ruin all the progress that's been made in these past five decades. We've always been a resilient people. When West visited nearly a century and a half ago, we realized that we had to adapt to modernize. You didn't realize you were forced into it. After trying to convince the 1920s through the 1940s, where ruthless military leaders led our nation's disaster, results revealed, even taking them out from those who've been victorious against us. You didn't take help, you were forced into accepting it. Some have questioned about the systems, but in the long run it has been for better. I either go back to the chaos of that terrible time, or I'd embrace the door of the new millennium by fighting back against the extremist elements. Therefore, it's the duty of every citizen of this nation to fight back against those who would bring chaos to our nation. I'm the hippies! We're going to war! We must fight to protect one of the strongest democratic regimes ever known. Burn on America. We must defend our way of life and our peaceful economy. We must stand up and fight back, and we must resort of sharpened bamboo stick to fend off the enemy and fall to the last man. And what is at stake here is not territorial expansion or defeating foreign troops. It's the very survival of our nation that's at stake. Go out and fight what is right. May all the Kami and Megami watch over our nation's defenders. Why not translate that? But Kami and Megami translate as gods and goddesses. It would be simple to say, may the gods. The Emperor did the right thing, just like his father before him, Genturimo said. Yes, but his father Ava was forced into it and had lost pretty much everything. The people are now on his and our side, Solo has said. Even they weren't before, they were helping Yoriko. Now, if we could only hear if we'll get any outside help, Usagi said. Yoriko heard the entire speech on portal radio. She was not pleased. The Emperor has betrayed us, Yoriko said. He will pay! Dr. Van Elven had heard the entire speech himself and decided that action had to be taken. Yoriko has now become too much of a liability to successfully carry out her mission, he said to some ninja soldiers. She will now blindly try to fulfill a bloodlust. Get my Iron Cross robotic arm and suit me up. I will go to the Imperial Palace myself and take care of matters. I could have done this plan before, but I chose to go with this prototype plane. Shut up! Back at SDF HQ, a private arrived with a message for Genturimura. I'm afraid it's not good, the pilot said. Americans will not be sending any help, nor anyone else for that matter. American base is far too damaged, and popular opinion is against them interfering in what they feel is an internal affair. Russian Chinese participants generally have expressed similar problems, but as limited resources and budgetary concerns. And it looks like we stand alone, Ben, Genturimura said. Time to fall back on my backup plan. Take Miss Morgendorf and her friends to Mr. Hamada's place in Narita. Pirate saluted and motioned to the others. You have to go someplace. We have an ace in the hole, was all the pirate said. It was a considerable drive and we were bombed out since the road in Tokyo. Went much better once they entered Chiba Ken. Once they got to Narita though, they were much improved. Finally, the SDF Humvee had reached residence of the Hamadas. They stepped out of the Humvee and went to the front door. The pirate rang the doorbell. Iyasura answered. Again, Iyasura is a surname, not a given name. I've been expecting you, he said. Come in. They entered the house. It was like most houses in post-war Japan, somewhat Western style, some of the touch of traditional Japanese living. Just me, everyone's shoes were removed. There I could see that for all the modern day conveniences, the house still had tatami mats on the floor. So important were these mats in the traditional Japanese architecture that rooms often measured how many of these mats could fit in them. Information about it is completely irrelevant to the story. Here in the living room, there's one of two rooms done in the traditional Japanese style, stood the tokonoma, or alcove for art, off to the side of the family shrine. I was receiving the radio along with the computer and a shortwave CB. You know, his whole thing would be much shorter if he didn't spend a lot of time describing unnecessary shit. Pretty impressive praise you have here, sir. Dario finally said, I am Hamada Iyasu, but almost everyone here calls me by my nickname. I had when I was once working for Toyota's American operations. Toyota? As in the car company? Harry. How do you get Harry from Hamada Iyasu? As you can tell, I don't let old age slow me down. My back problems, however. You see, I just happen to be a special officer for the SDF. Huh? Target identified. You see, I do have a lot of expertise in these matters. When the militaries took over our nation, I was contacted by a group of concerned Japanese Americans who were worried about our nation being involved with the Axis powers. I played the role of a good soldier, volunteered to be the old JIAAF, while at the same time giving information about upcoming attacks on American positions. Even after the unfortunate relocation of the Japanese American population, the American government thought I would be of service to them. I was even entrusted with a special mission that was sent to me by the famed Navajo code talkers. which you know out government was unable to decipher. Admit I did some things I was not proud of for both sides, but I was never suspected. When I had the opportunity to capture American POWs, I let them escape and beat them about my activities. How was he never suspected if he let prisoners go? When I was kept by Americans, I was told the top brass about my covert activities on behalf of the government. You are the first persons to warn the new Truman administration about the government was willing to sacrifice everything to save their nation. That's one of the reasons why the atomic bombs fell on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. And you have no remorse over that? That I said. Iyasu continued. I'll admit that I do feel remorse that many died in those two attacks. There's no matter some American POWs died as well. Did I see it atrocities made by everyone in the war, so it's a wash. What matters for here and now? Anyway, after the war, I did my part in reconstructing the nation. I assisted the occupation force in various matters, and after they left, I was contacted by my government about forming a special unit that would keep an eye on groups that would try to bring back militarism. How did they know about him? The unit was named Red Unit. For a special part of the SDF, which obvious reasons officially doesn't exist, I keep an eye on groups like the Naiva in case something like the present situation occurs. I keep tabs on both these groups via shortwave radio and the internet, as well as taking several risks in infiltrating their secret meetings, as well as take. I am seen as a hero by my neighbors. To them, I am not a traitor to what I did during the war or even now. You mean you tell them about your secret operations? How has he not been thrown in jail for that? There's no honor lost if you admit that you did wrong and wish to do penance. And we'd much prefer what we have now than to go back to those dark days of the past. Everyone stood there, silently amazed what Iyasu had told them. Why? He finally broke the silence. Come, I know why you are here. The plane is waiting for us in the back. Plane? He said. I stepped out and saw the Nick Verma back at guard. Any of you into airplanes? Iyasu said. I am, Darius said. Because the author is, so am I. Because I'm his closest avatar in this story. That's the Kawasaki Ki-45 Toru Night Fighter / Ground Attack Aircraft. Maximum speed 338 miles per hour. Power plant 2 Mitsubishi HA-102 14 cylinder rate. Ideal position engines rated at 1079 horsepower. Range of 1240 miles. Servicing of 33,000 feet. Armed with forward firing 37mm cannon. 2 obliquely mounted upward firing 20mm cannons. A 7.92mm machine gun in the rear observed position. The Nick, as we called it, was unusual for a Japanese aircraft since it had armoured gas tanks, as most other planes like the Zero didn't. And this plane, not the Zero, that made the first kamikaze attack against the American naval vessel in 1944. I see you know this plane very well, Iyasu said. Right now this old plane is the only airworthy craft we have against the Neo Zero. Wouldn't that be like using a beast shooter against an IBM, Dyer said. I have studied much of your Western world's religion, Iyasu continued. And if I recall, in both Judaism and Christianity, they didn't give a young man not much older than you named David much of a chance against someone named Goliath, who's a bit taller than most of your nation's basketball players. Remember, back in 1281, no one thought we stood a chance against a mighty Mongol Empire when they sent a vast armada against us. Then our Shinto priest prayed for divine intervention, and a massive storm sank much of the Mongol fleet. That is the origin of kamikaze, the divine wind. And much later on was it given to those soldiers and pilots who sacrificed themselves in fighting against the enemy during World War II. For what it's worth, Darius said, no one thought the English had any chance against the Spanish Armada back in 1588 either. They were told by bad weather as well. He has got a good laugh over that. Young lady, you're not like most Americans I have met. You're not so uptight. Oh, how many Americans have they actually met? The stereotype is not that they're uptight. It's that they're the opposite of uptight. They don't care about other cultures. Now, I guess I'll take you, pointed to Darius and Ami. Because I want you to, would you fondle my... work my levers, if you know what I mean. Let's get in the plane and take off. I have already let down the fence, so we'll taxi onto the street and take off from there. At Sume, Iyasu's wife went to Dane said, you can join me in the car and follow them. Fine by me, Dane said. I'll fly on my own and see if I can help in any way, Usagi said. As Iyasu, Daria, and Ami got into the Nick, Iyasu got to the pilot's controls and turned on the ignition. Ami sat next to him while Daria got in the rear observer's position. revered observers. The engine coughed to life as the propellers began spinning. Soon the lumbering plane was going down the backyard to the front and out onto the street where it got to take off position. Listen, so what happened to the house? He asked me, made a careful check of all systems. All systems go, he said, and pulled gently on the throttle and plane eased down the road and was soon airborne. He and Natsume followed in Ieyasu's car. The Sailor Moon took off and flew in the same direction. Final battle save Japan from the Naira was soon underway. Yoriko was flying over what was left of Tokyo. She had Black Monk time the CD player again. This time just listening to I Hate You, Larry Clark's screeching organ playing led into Gary Berg's overalls. Hey, well, I hate you with a passion, baby, yeah, I do. But call me, but you don't know, my hate's everlasting, baby. But call me, do you know why I hate you, baby? Huh? Do you know? But call me. Well, it's because you made me hate you, baby. Yeah. Call me. So he saw the Nick and Sailor Moon flying right towards her. Ha! All they can send against me is a rusty old World War II relic. Ick, did he not see the Sailor Senti flying alongside said relic? It's no contest, she sneered. You'll grab the Nick charging her HUD. She's ready to fly away, but Death Grip came and suddenly Sailor Moon parts right on top of her. That's what you get for not noticing her. All Yoriko could see was Sailor Moon's buttocks. God, get off of me! Yoriko yelled. Yoriko instinctively pulled back and got into a steep climb. Aye, Sailor Moon was thrown off, that gave the Nick a momentary edge. Ieyasu fired the forward cannon, sending a hail of bullets Yoriko's way. Damn it! Yoriko screeched. The bullets cut right through the Neo Zero, but it was pretty heavily armored, because it only got slight damage. Yoriko decided to arm Neo Sidewinders. Ieyasu saw that coming, somehow. She fired those missiles, we're done for, Ami said. See those infrared flares back there? Ieyasu said. Ami said, did. Light them and then throw them overboard on my mark, Ieyasu said. Ami did as Ieyasu said to her. She lit the flares. Luckily, these are somewhat similar to roadside flares, can be held for some time, but they're not very good flares. Yoriko aimed my hood again at the Nick. See you in hell, bastards! She yelled as he fired every available missile she had. Ieyasu saw it coming. No! He yelled. Ami dumped the flares overboard and missiles went right toward them, blowing up harmlessly, but it was a bit too close for comfort for everyone aboard. They dodged it. Yahoo! And I don't mean that internet search engine either, Ieyasu said. What in hell? Yoriko said. Yeah, that was my exact reaction to that last line. Sailor Moon saw what was going on and said, holy moly! Actually, I assumed he'd say, Nam Dakota, which roughly translates as, my words. Now the Nick had the edge. Ieyasu sent the forward gun blazing. Bullets ripped through the Neo Zero like lightning. The Neo Zero fired back, doing some damage of its own. Dara's lovingly holding to the trigger of her tail gun. A wind was whipping her head, he stood in her position. Somehow wearing her new armored bikini outfit, with her wind-tossed hair, she felt very sexy. Perhaps the sexiest she ever felt in all her life. The Neo Zero made another pass at the Nick, firing away like crazy. Two bullets whizzed just short of Dara, who fired back. God, I love an old-fashioned dogfight, he has instead. He's now remembering those days when he flew his old plane up against the Americans, but now this is different. He had American allies and were fighting for a free democratic Japan. So why is he remembering it? How much times have changed since 1945? If only most of his comrades were alive now, he could tell them about this. And they promptly got him for speaking treason. We were wrong for opposing Americans. By all right, we should have called my allies against the Nazis and the fascists, what he wished to say to them. Yeah, but then they still got him because Japan was fascist back then, and the Nazis had more in common. We were foolish to back their cause. We should have made them some type of economic association with our neighbours, more like the European Union, not the imperial expansion we sought. Yeah, I don't think that would have gone down well with them. Jimmy decided to adopt West technology and Western ways so he could stand as equals to them instead of being subservient. But he didn't adopt them until after the war. He must lead by example to show the rest of the world the way to a better day. But he was not so much worried to have passed the future. No matter what that future was, new ice age being the Crystal Tokyo or high-tech future like many wish, how do you know about the first one? Even the status quo is fighting for a future where freedom and democracy rule, not a return to reactionary rule. Hate to break it to you, mate. He's fighting for his future. He was fighting for Snags and Amis. In a sense, he was also fighting for dies as well. Why in a sense? Does he know he's going to die? He knew that even his own father opposed the Memphis, but was silenced by them. If only he was alive to see this. Yes, well, I doubt he'd be alive, since even if he hadn't been killed by the militarists, he'd be over 100. The fuselage was fast and furious now. Both planes suffered considerable damage. Somehow the superior speed and power of the Neo Zero was being to toe. Now it's time to play the end game of this battle. And he actually punished the Nixon, who was now right below the Neo Zero. Ami, Daria, aim for the drop tanks, he has said. Ami aimed the obliquely mounted, upward-firing gun at the top of the plane at the left tank, but Daria aimed her tail gun, which is our flexible mount, on the right tank. On my mark, fire, he has said. Got very close to the Neo Zero now. Yoko managed to pick them up on her radar. They think they can knock me out of a surprise attack, she sneered. I'll show them. He has his sense he was at the right position. Now! He yelled. All the guns are blazing at the drop tanks. Yoko's rage of fire the afterburners and launched a surprise attack of her own. Whoever won the bullet, which is especially reinforced and hard to pierce the armored tanks, managed to go right through the right tank. The afterburners were kicked in, it ignited. Yoko saw it ignite in horror. No! It's not possible! She screamed. She knew she only had seconds in which to act. Best be eject button and was thrown out of the Neo Zero. Now it went on its own for a few seconds before the right tank finally exploded. Soon the entire jet fighter was enveloped in flames, dropping to Tokyo Bay. Hey, when it landed into the water, it exploded with a loud boom. Yoko is now floating down towards Tokyo. So that's the end of the Neo Zero in the title. Now it's just the Misery Sensei debacle. Oh, Sailor Moon saw what happened. She got onto a radio she was carrying and said, when did she get a radio? You guys did it! She could hear a sound of celebration in the Nick. And the Nick, which is still air-weary despite all the damage inflicted on it. Diyasu turned to his comments and said, well done, ladies. Now if you care to give me a blowjob. I swear none of this is the loose dialogue from Ieyasu is in the office. It's all me trying to add some actual funny to this story. The Neo Zero may be destroyed, Harry, but we still have Yoriko to deal with, Darius said. All agreed to on that. They make their way back to Naruto and Jane radio from Natsume's car. We saw everything, guys. Way to go. Better not open the champagne yet, Jane, Darius said. As Yogi Berra says, it ain't over till it's over. Data 16, Tokyo game, set and match. Dr. Van der Helfen, now clad in his Iron Cross robotic armor. Armor was heading down the side of the street to Tokyo on his way to Imperial Palace. Iron Cross, eh? Yeah, wow. You know who I am, Spider-Man. Saint Leopardon. And he was not aware that the Neo Zero had been shot down. He couldn't see that whole dogfight. He's planning to deal with Yoriko eventually. She had gotten too big for her britches. You already mentioned this. He also knew that he had to take his next Hinotori immortality pill soon or suffer grave consequences. Which is why he's attacking the palace. When his name is street, he needs to go down in order to get to Imperial Palace. However, Ryu was blocking his way. Dr. Van der Helfen, I won't let you get away with this, Ryu said. Japan he wants to bring back has long been discredited. Get out of my way, traitor, Dr. Van Helfen said. He picked up a master and flung it right at him. Ryu got out of the way in time, then was bushwhacked by a sucker punch that sent him through a wall. Ryu slowly got up. On his bare forearms of a dragon and tiger tattoos that had been given to him after he was admitted to a sound peace. Clearly he doesn't get a whole tiger and dragon symbology. A wise man named Kwai Chang Kane, no, that's not a Chinese name, who met in his travels abroad, once said that strength and might was not all there was at all. Intelligence was important. Use your foe's strength against him. Yu went to Dr. Van Helven, launched a roundhouse kick. Dr. Van Helven swung a fist at him, instead knocked down a facade, sending bricks raining down on him. Wherever Dr. Van Helven shook that top and approached for Yu, Yu made a singing blast of solar energy from nowhere. Solar flare, discharge, attack! Yelled a voice. Solar energy knocked Dr. Van Helven down. Petro stepped out of some rubble. You evil man, he said. I am a solar warrior, servant to Amaterasu Omikami, goddess of the sun and defender of Japan. In the name of the sun, you are judged. How can we get it right for his original character, but wrong for the character who actually says it? It's Dr. Van Helven yelled in anger. I will kill you all! He charged at them. Ryu and the solar warrior now launched a double-barreled assault. It pounded him hard. Real hard. Oh god, that sounds more lewd than intending. Van Gogh's arm was beginning to buckle when finally it fell apart and exploded, ejecting Dr. Van Helven out of it. And he apparently survived the whole thing. Okay, just let me out. He was severely injured. Ryu and the solar warrior approached him. Give yourself up, the solar warrior said. Never, Dr. Van Helven said. Once I take this last Hinotori Matadi pill, I'll be as strong as ever. He took it out of his vial and was about to put it in his mouth, but in his haste to swallow it, it missed his mouth, rolled across the street, and rolled into a sewer. Dr. Van Helven screamed in agony. No! It is the last one! No! 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 Suddenly a hideous transformation took place. Dr. Van Helven was aging rapidly before Ryu and the Solar Warrior. His hair turned grey and fell out. His skin wrinkled up. His bones sagged in arthritic pain. All this rapid aging proved to be too much, and Dr. Van Helven fell down dead from a heart attack. This is not the end of that. Suddenly the body began to rapidly decompose. The skin rotted away to nothing, then the muscles, intestines and sinews as well. Then the skeleton rapidly turned to dust and was blown away in all directions with the wind. Why did the body disintegrate? Wouldn't it just rot? This is the horrible end of Dr. Helmut Van der Helfen, former genetic expert to Hitler, shadowy leader of the new Imperial Rule Assistance Association. We and the solar warriors saw the whole thing. Now he's gone to Yomi, the land of the dead, where he belongs. Or as most Americans call it, hell, the solar warrior said. Now we have but one more enemy to face. Amazana Yoriko, Ryu said. Ryu got out his portal communicator to contact the Sailor Sensei. It was time to find Yoriko. Sailor Sensei, can you hear me? He said. I hear you, Darius said. Ryu asked, where is Amazana Yoriko? I think she parachuted her way to a Mitsubishi building, Darius replied. We'll meet you there, Ryu said. He and the Soul Warrior headed off in that direction. Yoriko had landed on the roof of Mitsubishi building. Now she was alone. I will never surrender, she said to herself. Now she took a look at the streets below. The Inaira soldier engaged in fierce fights with the SDF now. He had everyone taken the Emperor's message to heart and were now fighting to rid Japan of the Inaira. Apparently not, since it's just the SDF. Those fools, he said. They think they can defeat us, they're crazy. From the door of the stairway leading to the roof was kicked open, and Sailor Moon, along with the other Sailor Senti, Pixie Mask, Jane, Trent, Jesse, Matt, his cousin Brian, who's appearing for the first time, Jody, Ryu, and the Soul Warrior entered. Amazon and Yoriko, give yourself up. Up, said Sailor Moon. I am a pretty soldier, eternal Sailor Moon, champion of love and justice. These are the Sailor Senti and our allies. In the name of the moon and in the name of a free and democratic Japan, we will punish you. Yes, you finally nailed it. Good on you. You're already too late, Yoriko yelled. We bombed most of Tokyo to rubble, and even now the civilian government's thinking of surrendering. At long last, my father, Gen Tojo Hideki, will be vindicated. As long as my master, Amaterasu Omikami, goddess of the sun, shines above the heavens, I swear you'll never succeed in your evil plans, Solo said. Once the Inaira has seized power, you will all be destroyed. Oi, like I said, Dario wanted to cut to the heart of the matter. After, why is it, Dario said, but your organization wants to bring back the former tyranny that brought so much suffering to millions of innocent people. Do not question me, Yoriko said. Ed, we want to make Japan the leader of the world. Never mind, you've had the military government by rule during World War II, it's sponsored such things as the attack on Manchuria, the rape of Nanjing, the attack on Pearl Harbor, the Bataan Death March, POW camps, the Korean Comfort Women, and other atrocities. That I said, certainly you're planning to do all that and worse. I have assigned you wanted for all you Ming time, you minx! Yoko said. She took a vial of the only Hino Ori immortality pill that's left in the world. Just someone finds a formula and reinvents it, and swallowed them all. She screamed as a hideous transformation took place. She grew to be 50 feet tall and now had horns on her head, green hair, and was wearing a tiger skin suit. She now had sharp teeth and sharp claws. She transformed into a gigantic Oni or Ogre. Ogre. Ooh, you've really made it mad now, Daria, Jane said. Tell me about it, Daria replied. Fall back, Sailor Moon said to everyone. And Yoko now seized Daria and threw her onto the roof again, then stepped on her with her left cloven foot.
Now I'll crush you like Japan will do to all who oppose her,
Yoko said.
Then I will kill you all. All.
We got to save Daria, Sailor Moon said. And every sailor sent and least her attack, some for old, some for new. Moon Princess Halation! Shabon Spray, freezing! Mars Soul Fire, ignite! It's fire soul. Jupiter Thunder, crash! Venus Crescent Beam, smash! Saturn Spear, air attack! Uranus Sword, attack! No, Uranus Space Sword, shot! Neptune Deep, submerge! Pluto Mirror, attack! No, Neptune is Wonder Mirror, Pluto is the staff. GB Moon, Love Beam, attack! Athena Mass Lunge, extended walking creature creeps as well. I don't get a cool name! View launched to a roundhouse kick. Solar then launched to his Solar Flare Discharge Attack! It's all seemed to be in vain. Yoko is still standing. Now she stepped hard on Daria. Mom, Dad, Quinn, I didn't realize you'll never hear me say it, but I've always loved you, Daria said to herself. Seeing there was a dazzling flash of light that blinded everyone, there was a loud voice that pierced the air. I am Amaterasu Omikami, God of the Sun and Protector of Japan. I heard to please my people to deliver them from their peril, and I will save them for a battle of victory of mine. I was on a Yoriko, in the name of the Sun of my people that I care for deeply, you are judged. So God only chooses now to intervene, not any but five much worse attacks the sailors sent you been through. My child, now just on my concept way, use the power of the Miko that are yours by birthright to banish the demon. Ray took a demon banishment scroll, but have a name, it's an Ofuda, and said, this is for you, Grandpa, Akurio Taisan, and flung it at the creature, sticking to its forehead. Ami, Daria, freeze her, Simon said. Both said,
Shaman Spray, freezing,
and froze Yoriko solid. Now, Sailor Moon, Amaterasu Kami said. Finish her off, destroy this demon and end this war. Oh, Sailor Moon took out their moon set to point at the creature. Moon Princess Halation! And magic beams hit the creature with such force it exploded with a loud BOOM! Everyone was knocked off their feet by a violent explosion. Ozen, Daria, however, was blown over and nearly fell to the street, save for her grabbing a railing. Daria was hanging on for dear life. Suddenly, arm grabbed her, and Daria grabbed it with both hands and was taken to safety. Turned out to be Jane. Thanks, Jane, Daria said. I owe you one. Now to end this battle once and for all, Amaterasu Omikami said. Suddenly, fiery shafts shot out of her fingers, and they travelled all around Tokyo, incinerating every last Naima ninja. Murder is only wrong if you're not a god. Suddenly, it was all over. Amazona, Yoriko, and Naira were obliterated. Yeah, the dark clouds that were hanging over Tokyo began to dissipate, and the sun began to shine through. Versus the sunlight dissipates the storm clouds, a new era dawns in Japan. Amaterasu Omikami said, Amazona, Yoriko, and Naira have been destroyed. Peace reigns again. Now that's incredibly anticlimactic. I want to congratulate all of you for helping me stop these deadly adversaries. As token my favour, receive these. Once again, fiery shafts emerge from their fingers. This time, with solar fire, it defines the gemstones. These solar gemstones serve as a mind of your heroic deeds in saving my people. Amaterasu Omikami said, Keep with pride and pass them on to your children and grandchildren. Mind the time you saved my people from tyranny. And now I must leave you. Come, my brother, you'll return to the heavens. I'll leave you with my blessing. May you live long and healthy lives as long as the sun shall shine in the skies. Where's the two gods left our plane of existence for theirs? Who's the second god? Everyone stood their speeches for a minute. Finally, Sailor Moon said, "We did it! We all did it! We saved Japan!" They could hear the SDF soldiers below seeing Kimi Gaio again, fly by a chorus of Banzai! 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 A new era dawned in Japan, and the world was never going to be the same. A few days later, a huge crowd had gathered in the throne room of the Imperial Palace. Yes, there are ambassadors, members of the Diet, and SDF soldiers, sailors and airmen, as well as the Prime Minister, the Cabinet, and the Imperial Family. Also there was the representative-elect Nagai. Despite the horrible damage Sohio suffered, the by-election went on as scheduled, and he won by a landslide. Aye, the Sailor Senshi, Ryu, the Solar Warrior, Gen Toriyama, and Jane were all going to receive the Order of the Rising Sun, highest medal Japan could bestow. They all entered the room, and everyone smartly stepped aside to allow them passage. Walked up to the Emperor and stopped in front of him, bowing deeply. "Honored heroes," the Emperor began, "today a grateful Japan gives to you the highest award this nation can bestow. Oh, and above and beyond the call of duty, the baby above and beyond the call of duty, the Order of the Rising Sun, wear these medals of pride. Remember the sacrifice you made to save our nation in peril." The Emperor then pinned the medals on each of them. After that, the crowd cheered, "Banzai!" 5 times. Gento then stepped forward to say a few words. "I want to commend the brave actions made by all those who were under my command in this situation. We have fought against impossible odds, but we succeeded. But I do not know if I am worthy of such high merit. I must commend a shortcoming to you that occurred 15 years ago. I was on patrol that day, and the Soviets shot down the KO jetpack, wandered into their airspace. It should have done something to avert the tragedy, but we felt bound by Article 9. Clearly, none of you ever read it. Though we've been cleared of negligence, what you shouldn't have been, I still feel some moral responsibility for what happened because my sister and brother-in-law were on board. Now I can begin to atone for my shortcomings." Mr. Makoto continued, "I hereby vow to all of you that I will take care of my niece Kino Makoto, whose parents were on board that plane, now finance her college education, she'll live with my wife and children as well as myself, she'll once again have a family." The crowd applauded, tears of joy running down Makoto's face. Why, he basically just admitted he's a pretty terrible parental figure. If anything, I wouldn't get up with this guy at all. Dai clapped the others, meanwhile he knew that he had to catch a flight after this. Then small matters he had to take care of his duty-free shop before us. At Narita Airport, Dai, Ain, Jesse, Jody and Matt were going to take the next flight to Lawndale. There were some matters to take care of first. "Well," I said, "since I didn't register, I lost my tuition deposit. Now I'll have to wait another year for my pre-med. Besides, I don't think I'm ready for it yet anyway." "I'd call Ami-chan," I said. "We need you big time." "Guess it means my career as Sailor Mercury is over," Daria said. "Most certainly is," Luna said. "Ami, Daria, grab onto my tail. Now!" They did, and the Sailor Mercury powers are transferred back to Ami. "Well," Dai said, "back to just being a mere mortal." "Hey," Jane said, "you have your ability to put down people." "Dai," Sagi said, "on behalf of all the Sailor Senshi, thanks for all your help. If you ever get a chance to visit Lawndale, I'll look you up. Keep in touch with us, okay?" "We will," Dai said. "Mikey," Brian said, "but nice to meet you again, even if it was brief. Next time you go on leave, drop by," Max said. "I'm going to miss you guys," Dai said, and hugged all the Sailor Senshi. "Yeah, and I'm set back, the Lawndale flight was now boarding. We've got to go now," Dai said. "Keep her faith." Dai and her friends went down the gate. "Wait, how do her friends getting on the plane? They don't have passports." "Farewell, Dai and Morgendorfer, and Godspeed," Usagi said. Sailor Senshi returned to Tokyo. It's now midnight. Most of the Sailor Senshi with their parents emerged in shelters that were set up around the area. Usagi's parents hadn't returned to the resort yet. She and Chibi Yusa were being of Luna and Rain, Mamoru's apartment. "Oh, now you get it right." Sagi and Mamoru were sleeping together. Sagi got up, put on a robe, walked across about past the couch where Luna, Rain, Chibi, Yusa were sleeping, and stepped in onto a balcony. You could see the horrific damage that Tokyo suffered. Mamoru then joined her. "Mamoru-chan," Sagi said, "what a horrible thing that has just happened here, and with all the evil that is still rampant in this world, Will we ever realize Crystal Tokyo? Perhaps the bomb came to pass exactly the way everyone thought it would, Mamu said. It is still possible. Maybe it's up to us to make it happen. Tokyo will be rebuilt, and it will be people like us who will rebuild it. It will take people like Governor Guy to realize that vision, that future we're all fighting for. Besides, I think I can make a difference here and now. Tomorrow I'm going to announce I want to see Komeito nominated for Governor of Tokyo. Wait, why? You're interested in medicine, not politics. I won't mind if you're my first lady. I said, Mamo-chan, you asked me to marry you? Come on, Eileen. Oh, I swear I'm not mean. Mamo replied, yes, Usagi. Then, Auntie Saki, in that case, of course. Mamo then pointed out, Stein said, Yukino Asagi, take a look around you. From the ashes, we'll build a better future for all of us. If that isn't worth fighting for, then what is? Please, we have to fight for it. Let us do that side by side, husband and wife. And then kissed and returned to bed. Made love and they fell asleep. Mamu's head laying across Usagi's breast. Usagi then said to herself, we'll fight for a better future, Queen Serenity, and we'll do it together. At Lawndale International Airport, Helen, Jake, and Quinn are waiting for Daria's flight to arrive. When are they going to get here? Jake said. Your airline, Helen said. Always running behind schedule. Suddenly, Daria and her friends came down the gate. I ran up to Daria and hugged her. Welcome home, sweetheart, Jake said. I'm so happy that you're back. Quinn, Daria said. I have this for you. It's a box. What's in it? Quinn asked. I hope it's not a bomb. Quinn, Helen said. Open it and see, Daria said. Quinn did, and a very beautiful kimono was inside. Quinn held it to her and said, oh, Daria, this is so beautiful. I'm going to wear it to the next meeting of the fashion club. How are we going to figure out how you got it without coming to the conclusion that Daria is your sister and not your cousin? Man, am I ever glad to be back home, Trent said. You know, Trent, Daria said, I have to agree with you. Since it was a weekend when she arrived back, Daria spent Friday night at her house, then spent Saturday at Jane's place. That night, she and Trent had a frank talk about their feelings for each other. They wound up sleeping together. It was midnight now and they were lying in bed. Daria laid her head across Trent's chest. He's trying to find some words, but what he said at first was, Trent, take a good look at me and ask me if I'm really small-breasted. Trent replied, Daria, no matter how big those things are, you're still a beautiful woman to me. Like you. Trent, I'm glad we finally admit that we love each other. It's been a special night for me. Well, ready to finally confess your feelings to me. Trent began to reply, well, I spoke to that Mamu cat, and he told us like it was for him when he first met that Usagi babe. He told me he once hated her and called her Dumpling Head. Over time, he realized how special she was to him. But he didn't have the guts to say it at first. Now we're real close. Man, Mamu gained the courage to finally speak out. I'm glad he did. And I'm glad he did too. Daria said, he grabbed some body oil and began rubbing it on Trent. Oh god, Daria now felt good being nude. And so did Trent. Jane heard everything that was going on for the war and smiled to herself. At last, my brother's admitted he's crazy for Daria. Oh yeah, she said to herself. Hell, maybe someday we'll get married and have kids and I will be a good dancer and teach them to be artists like me. Jane went off to sleep with a self-satisfied smirk. Why not just simply become an artist yourself? Oh, that seems a lot... You have your own kids and teach them to be artists. That sounds a lot simpler. Emperor, okay, just give me a minute to find the music. I just paused the video for a minute. And we're back. I found the music and I just need to wait for this ad to go by. Just give me a few minutes. I'll pause the video again. Okay, after spending Sunday at home, Daria returned to school. First, she was a bit apprehensive since she was an outcast. When she entered, it seemed everyone was asking questions about what had happened and what she did. Now that school was letting out for day, everyone was crowding around her. You can start to tell me who does your clothes, Sandy said. That combat fatigue look is so chic. Wanna go to my party this Friday night? Brittany said, twirling her hair around her finger and staring space. I know some guys who might be interested in you. Thanks, but I'm already spoken for, Daria said. Yo, Daria, you're an okay person, Gavin said. If you ever want to join the fashion club, you're welcome to, they said. I think that just a few days ago nobody wanted to talk to you, Jane said. I just hope my 50 minutes of fame lasts a bit longer than most others, Daria said. I saw Quinn coming with her boyfriends, Joey, Jeffy, and Jamie. How many boyfriends does he have? And this is my heroic sister Daria, Quinn said. I thought you was your cousin, Joey said. That was all rumors, replied Quinn. She really is my sister and I'm proud of it. Suddenly, Upchuck arrived. Make way, Nupchuck said. Want to go my place for some tutoring, if you know what I mean?
Ah!
Leave me alone, Nupchuck, screamed Quinn. Ah, novice Quinn, in Darius said.
Sharon Spray freezing!
Nupchuck was frozen up to his neck. Already gave up all of Sailor Mercury's powers, Jane said. So much for a secret identity, am I right? I just need to look for the next music cue. I'll be back for the meeting in a second. And Jerry replied, got all of them, Jane. After all, I have to teach some idiots here a lesson. Then come on, Jane said, let's go get a pizza. He flung her arms around dying Quinn and left along with the others. Upchuck was all alone. Oh, and he began to scream. Hey, is anyone going to get me caught out? Anyone? Help! Mrs. DiMartino stormed there. I've been waiting a long time for this child, said, and I'm going to relish this. And what might I be trying to tell you for the longest time? I'm just asking, I'm not sure, Mr. DiMartino. Suddenly Mr. DiMartino yelled,
shut up!
He left Upchuck where he was. The lights turned off and the doors locked. Upchuck now began to shriek as now his voice was hostile.
Help! Help! Hell!
Upchuck kept this up for a few minutes and then he said, why do I was getting 3 seconds. Epilogue. Yes, this long ass thick it actually won't end, but it's like still a few good few lines, and then there's a load of other stuff which I won't be reading. I'll just be reading this very short epilogue. A government investigation led by representing the guy revealed that the Nightmare was a deep-rooted conspiracy that involved some corporate executives, some non-commissioned SDF officers, even some minor bureaucrats. Massive arrests were made. Hey, Chiba Mamu won the election to fill out in the guy's term as governor of Tokyo, Jomari Yusagi. They soon had a child, Chiba Yusa. The older Chiba Yusa then returned to her time. Why didn't you do that earlier? Ray took over as chief priest of a reconstructed Sendai Hill Shrine. That's not the name. The home dimension ability until only child Xavier is a stronger telepath for her on Earth. So, the X-Men are canon in this now? Why? I eventually did go to pre-med in Germany and fulfilled a complete medical study in the United States sometime later. Later joined the staff of Mayo Clinic. The Mayo Clinic, really? Surely there's somewhere more reputable. Helped find a cure for childhood leukemia. As opposed to regular leukemia. Makoto joined the Japanese Olympic team, won several gold medals in track and field in the 2004 Games in Athens. And Gencho Emera eventually was named to the SDF Joint Chiefs of Staff. What the hell happened to Minako? Hamdai Ieyasu declined to be awarded the Order of the Rising Sun, saying that serving his nation was reward enough. He died shortly thereafter, his ashes were scattered from his beloved Nick over Tokyo Bay. But Nick is now at the SDF Museum, and his family receives no royalties. The soul of warriors still fights the truth and justice to this very day. He's at various events which will probably be someday be told in another tale. I hope not. This man truly changed from a near zero affair. Fully apologised for what he did in World War II and promised to help better relations with its neighbours and the world community at large. He mocked all it was what it was already doing. But still, Essentia is still committed to a better future for Japan and the world. Federal investigators revealed that the Lawndale militia had extensive firepower in reserve, and many upstanding members of the community were part of it. There were many convictions, and most were either sentenced to death or life without parole. Darien and Trent eventually married. They have a daughter, Yusagi, and a son, Mamoru. Oh, God. Her Aunt Jane is getting her artistic talents honed. Darien eventually became a lawyer like her mother, successfully argued the case before the Supreme Court that struck down the 1996 welfare reform laws as unconstitutional because it violated poor people's due process rights. Trent and his band Mystic Spiral eventually signed a multi-record deal with Warner Brothers Records and has 7 multi-platinum albums with scores of top 10 and number 1 hits. But I bet none of it's on Apple Music or Spotify. As he was eventually found guilty of embezzlement and sentenced to 30 years in jail, Mr. DiMartino then became a new principal rather than the actual vice principal. I had admitted that he'd used ineligible players in the game in question and forfeits it. Lawndale thus won the conference title, eventually the state title. I thought, Israeli troops wreak their vengeance on Islamic Jihad for the JL hijacking. The Imam al-Kabaz was killed when a missile struck his home. Outstanding indictments against the others who were involved are pending in American and Japanese courts. As for your announcer, he plans to finally get a good night's sleep and take a month off from his computer. He needed it. I wish I could take a month off, but I've got a lot of assignments for uni. He needs it. This is the end. Beautiful friend, the end. Jim Morrison, The Doors, the end. The ever-loving end. And I'm not going to be reading the rest since that would drag us on. So I'll just do a final thought to this story. It's objectively, it's really terrible. The author shows that he knows nothing about any of the subjects he's covering, and yet feels really, has the audacity to present himself as an expert. He fills it with unnecessary sexual humour, Omar, all caps, apps, and God knows what else, along with random Japanese seemingly out of nowhere. Not to mention a plot that has way too many characters to make sense. Ends. And there's also the fact he that, yeah, pretty much said every major complaint I've had over these videos. I'll just be saying good night, and it's good night for me. I'll be back to full time with Super Sentai vs. Super Sentai. I probably won't be doing this fixed sequel or prequel since I'm not familiar with the material in them.